top 5 healthcare IT certification. If you want to come into IT in a healthcare sector where most of the money currently right now, we are seduced by the money in the healthcare IT infrastructure, supporting the healthcare IT infrastructure, whether you want to become a computer certified technician, whether you want to do the networking in a hospital or in a clinic, whatever you want to do in the healthcare, it really doesn't matter unless you have some kind of professional healthcare IT certification. Why? If you screw with a single some kind of MRI machine with network equipment, it can cause really a death or it can have injury to the patient. That's why there are some certification which make sure you even understand some kind of medical stuff in the medical world of healthcare while you are doing your own healthcare IT support. Now here are the 5 certification. Now let's move to the screen.
Number 5 is CPHIT Certified Professional in Healthcare. So I have just included the link in the description box below. This is one of the recognized certificate in the world, but not so much. You have to check with the clinic or with the hospital which you are going to provide your IT support infrastructure. Make sure to check with them. I mean, this is one of the real certificate that I mean is a really good certificate. I mean, you will learn a lot if you just go to the certification target audience. You can see, I mean, the professional training and certification program is targeted to those responsible for planning, select, implementing, using, managing electronic health record, and then you can read everything. If you go to the main page, it's very hard to find. Even I have included a link. Just Google certified professional in healthcare and then you will be, they will bring you to the overview, which is this one, CPHIT, certified professional in healthcare. This is a certification. The certified professional health information system indicate that holder has mastered the common body knowledge of covering, selecting, implementing, using, managing electronic health information technology and electronic record. The CPHIT curriculum introduced the use of health information technology in any setting with continued care. To find the information is quite hard, so I have done a search for you. To get a CPHIT or certified professional in healthcare, you need to pay a $495 for the exam fees. And then if you fail the exam, the retake exam fees is $395. Plus, you have to pay $100 per annually for the renew or maintenance fee. So it's very simple, $495 for the exam. But if you are taking the exam in a, some kind of training package, then they will give you some discount for the exam. Yes, the exam is $495, quite expensive. But again, it depends. I mean, some hospital, some clinic, some healthcare, what kind of ever, I mean, healthcare it is, whether it is an elderly home or whatever it is, they, I mean, put some kind of certification name, I mean, on their job description. If they put CPHIT, so it means they are looking for someone who will have CPHIT, but still, it's one of a good certification. Do not go with the ugly website. This website look like it's from early 90s. Anyway, ignore the look of the website. You should focus on, is your certificate recognized or not? Now let's move to number 4. Number 4 is RHIA or Registered Health Information Administrator. To do this certification, you need a bachelor degree. For the minimum requirement is, if you can't fulfill the minimum requirement, then you can't even sit for the exam. So the exam fees is $299, much cheaper than the CPHIT, which is costing you $495. This is one of the very well recognized in the healthcare world. I mean, Register Health Information Administrator. So by the name, you can already see what does it mean. Here is something: working a critical link between care provider, payer, and patient. So it means that you are will be working overall in the infrastructure, and then you will be working as an admin, but you will be a healthcare admin. Here you can see, is an expert in managing patient health information, which is the same electronic record, and then basically possess compressed knowledge of medical. This is one of the things, I mean, CPHIT lack. So whenever you're working, you need to have some medical knowledge, because you don't want to screw, you don't want to basically turn off some kind of oxygen machine with your weird networking plug, you plug in, everything go down. You need to know one stupid mistake or one error can cause someone life. That's why entering into healthcare with your normal bachelor degree in IT with computer A plus, network plus, security plus, very hard. I mean, for example, if I am a doctor or I'm running a normal clinic or I'm the manager of the hospital, I'm the director of the hospital, I wouldn't let anyone come even with a 10 year experience, even with a PhD in IT, to come in my hospital and then touch my medical equipment. I don't want anyone to die. To be honest with you, that's why there are these certifications which you provided. These are not the certification which you can basically study on your own by a book. This kind of certificate require a practical training. So it is here you can see health information. This is one advertisement, anyway, ignore it. So the normal requirement is a academic bachelor degree. You can see RHIA applicant must meet one of the following eligibility requirement: successfully complete academic requirement at the bureaucrat level. I mean, which again mean a bachelor degree. If you can't understand what do mean a bureaucrat level, again, telling you it's a bachelor degree, I have done my research, I have dig into it, and a graduate from HIM, it's a one or another program, anyway, this will know the part. So $299 minimum requirement, a bachelor degree, they really doesn't care if you are 20 year veteran in IT, they will need a bachelor degree, and in this you will learn medical information also. I highly, to be honest with you, recommend, again, it depends in which hospital, in which clinic, or in which kind of healthcare infrastructure you are going to support, in which care of healthcare sector you are going to apply as the IT admin or just a normal IT job. Now let's jump to number 4. No, it's number 3. SCIP, not number 4. Anyway, excuse me. So quite a jargon word they have put inside in the HCISPP certification name. Healthcare Information Security Privacy Practitioner. Anyway, let's look at the domain. For getting the certification, you need to pay a $349 for an exam, and then you can see what kind of domain it covers. It has 6 domain: healthcare industry, regulatory environment, privacy, information, risk, third party risk, and then who should obtain the HCISPP certification. This is one of the things you should basically know, is this certification is for you or not. You can see who is the compliance officer, who is the information security manager. You will be thinking, Jimmy, I'm just a normal IT support guy, only I have CCNA or I have CCNP, only I have CompTIA plus. Is this certification for me? Definitely. The downside, it doesn't require a bachelor degree, but the biggest downside, it requires 2 year experience. Again, it depends. If you are graduate from with a bachelor degree IT with no experience, then you can't basically get the certification. If you are having some 2 year experience but without a bachelor degree, then thumbs up. You can see what kind of jobs you are working in, you can get the certification. Anyways, do not try to fall into these healthcare certification. Try to be like the next coolest thing in the world. They failed. I mean, privacy officer do not need SCIP. Risk analyst do not need SCIP. SCIP need these. Most of the jobs are non-technical job, excluding information security manager, and then this one also information technology manager. Rest of the jobs are non-technical, then they really don't need. And then you can see who should employ SCIP: hospital, healthcare. So the main focus of this one is again the healthcare. I mean, they will not teach you only about the medical and then supporting IT information. They will teach you about risk assessment. I mean, again, you will be thinking, what do really risk assessment mean? Risk assessment means when you're going to, again, doing some kind of networking, when you're going to install some new server, you have to do the information risk assessment. If something go wrong, if by your mistake all of the servers shut down, and then most of the patient, I mean, who were some kind of machine in a CPU, how should you react and what is the risk? Always there is a risk whenever you work in a healthcare IT. I mean, for example, even I'm just trying to work on a doctor computer, trying to clean his computer. Most of the computer in a hospital healthcare still running Windows XP, but they are never connected to the internet. That's why they're still running fine. So, for example, if I'm trying to do some kind of update on the doctor computer or on the surgeon computer, suddenly by my super mistake, there's a virus came, and then the virus affects over the network, and then suddenly three computer dies. Suddenly, I mean, they shut down due to any kind of normal reason when a virus hit it, or basically the screen is locked, whatever happened. What is the risk, how it will affect the patient, and then how it will affect the overall healthcare, whether it's hospital, clinic, operating environment. So you should always do risk assessment. This number 5 and 4 does not include risk assessment. And then again, SCP is one of the really well recognized certificate in the world. Again, it depends. I mean, someone would like to get a CPHIT, someone like to just become a normal RHIA, but this one is again one of very well recognized over these two. Now let's jump to number 2. Number 2 is CAHIMS main. Number 2 is CAHIMS. So you will be thinking, what really CAHIMS mean? Quite a jargon word, isn't it? CAHIMS means Certified Associate in Health Information and Management System. So to take this exam, you need a high school diploma, not a bachelor requirement. Much better. A lot of people who are working in IT, they really do not have their bachelor degree. They start in their early ages. So the fees is $225 US, and again you can check out the certification fees. The certification fees normally change. As a recording, currently is $225, which is really freaking cheap compared to like $400, $300, $345. And then again you can see why you should get certified. You can distinguish yourself in increasing competitive marketplace. To be honest with you, there's no competition currently in healthcare IT. We really need more healthcare IT professional, but there are really few who have some kind of real certification, who really goes through some kind of technical IT degree. I mean, there really don't exist any real IT in healthcare. Normally you can get a bachelor in IT or bachelor in computer science. You can't get something like bachelor in information technology, health, nothing. And then you can see, again, I'm a big fan of HIMS. Again, it depends in which country you are located. If you ask me, should you go with this one or this one, personally I will say go with SCIP. I mean, as if I have more recognition, you're thinking, Jimmy, why you're not putting this one on number 3 and this one number 2? Because HIMS is very, how to say, whenever the HR department of a hospital recognize, they easily recognize HIMS as compared to this. This is recognized by the doctors, the professional who are really working as a nurse. I mean, but the problem again is that a doctor is not going to hire you. The HR department is going to hire you. Yes, they are given some training of medical. Again, the problem is that they prefer HIMS. Then what I can do? I mean, both are equal certification. I mean, both teach you that similar thing. Anyways, let's move to number 1. If you move to number 1, then it really doesn't matter which certification you take, because number 1 is number 1. Number 1. Number 1. Best of the best. I mean, there's no reason to get another certification before you get. If you get CompTIA healthcare IT technician, then it's better you take this one, this one, this one. It doesn't really matter. I mean, you can take the CPIT, you can take the Registered Health Information Administrator. It doesn't really matter. But CompTIA healthcare IT technician is the foundation. First, get the certification. Again, I'm telling you, this is one of the cheapest healthcare IT certification. It's only costing you $109. To be honest with you, it's very well recognized. I mean, CompTIA healthcare IT technician is really well recognized. CompTIA is putting a lot of marketing. I mean, they are trying to basically throw the fish in the healthcare world to make sure that their HR department, their doctors, their whatever medical staff recognize healthcare IT technician. My personal opinion is that, I mean, normally getting a job with only a healthcare IT technician, it can be a little bit harder. But if you get some kind of training package, I mean, these all rest of the four require practical training in a classroom base, you have to pay like it depends. I'm not sure, around $1,000, which is excluding the exam fee. My personal opinion is get this one and then get a RHIA, Register Health Information Administrator, then you can easily go into the healthcare world. So here you can see the CompTIA healthcare IT technician certification cover the knowledge and the skill required to deploy support healthcare IT in US clinical system. Again, I'm telling you, it's all depending which country you're located, but CompTIA healthcare IT technician is not only basically recognized in USA, it's recognized as well. This is just getting so much famous in the world. I was just checking out some blogs, some news website. I mean, most of the content they covered, they are telling you to have a CompTIA plus. If you don't know, I'm already CompTIA plus certified, or over 500 IT training. Only the downside is this, I mean, they will not teach you medical stuff compared to this one RHIA, which will basically teach you the medical stuff. This is pure technical healthcare IT technician certificate. So here's what I will say: get this one and then get SCIP or RHIA. It's again depend, at least you need 2 certification. This will basically build your foundation technical, and rest of the build with your medical knowledge and your risk assessment. And then you can see what kind of domain is covered. I mean, USA regulatory requirement. Most of the international or whatever hospital you're going to work in, for example, even South Africa follows normal similar USA regulatory requirement, even India followed, then it doesn't really matter. Organizer behavior, IT operation, medical business operation, security, and then you can check out the exam objective. Now let's move to me.
As you have seen that these are one of the 5 best recognized healthcare IT certification, a lot of people are going to go mad on me. They are going to say, Jimmy, how dare you comparing the RHIA, Registered Healthcare Information Administrator, with the healthcare of CompTIA IT technician. A lot of people are going to say that CompTIA healthcare IT technician is not really worth it. They only teach you some kind of theoretical IT stuff. But the main problem is that the rest of the certificates, some focus a little bit on IT, some focus more on medical. If you want to get into IT of healthcare, first you need to be a perfect in your own field, which is IT. This CompTIA healthcare IT technician certificate is only costing $109. I mean, you could easily buy the book, study it, and then move to the rest of it. You suddenly you are thinking that you're going to take the CPHIT, or you're going to take the RHIS, or you are going to take a SCIP certification. The main problem is that those certifications are really very hard. I mean, you can easily get lost, you can easily fail 4 or 5 times before you pass. That's why I'm telling you, CompTIA healthcare IT technician, even the HR department love it. I mean, it depends. If you don't have really any kind of medical or work in a hospital experience, maybe the doctor will not hire you, but you can easily get a call. You can easily basically call for the interview by the CompTIA healthcare IT technician. Again, do not get me wrong. CompTIA healthcare IT technician is number one certificate because due to its popularity, beauty is really freaking cheap, only $109. And thirdly, due to this CompTIA healthcare, I mean, CompTIA is really well recognized. I mean, from rest of the organization, CompTIA really put high standard certification. So take this one and then decide which of you want to take rest of 4. I mean, you could take the, for example, you can take the CPHIT, you can take the RHIA, which is Registered Health Information Administrator, or you can take the SCIP, or basically you can take the CHIMS, which is number 2. Again, it depends in which hospital you want to work. Everyone have different standard. There is currently not any international standard for hiring the IT staff in a healthcare environment. I mean, there are really no international standard currently right now. Maybe in the future can be. These are only 5 certifications which can help you to get into the world of IT with really freaking money. And do not just believe on them. There's really no competition. And subscribe to my channel. It's me, Jimmy. Bye bye.